Hello all, this is Neil from Edureka, and welcome to this interesting session on Internet of Things projects. Now, in this session, we will be talking about the top 7 projects which are outstanding themselves in the Internet of Things domain. Now, before we talk about each of these projects, let me start off with a simple introduction to what is Internet of Things. Internet of Things basically is a concept or a technology which aims to connect all the devices to the Internet and help them communicate with each other using the internet as a medium. Now, these devices can be anything. It could be a TV, it could be a mobile phone, it could be a watch, even your car as such. Anything that can be connected to the internet can be considered as a device for Internet of Things. The intention of using internet as a medium of communication is to help you achieve a wider and a greater reach with respect to these devices. Again, the end aim of Internet of Things is to help you create a smart world that's out there. Now let's talk about each of these projects. Let's start with number 7, which is a biometric system. Now, a biometric system is something that we always encounter on our daily basis as well, because we always either use a fingerprint sensor or we use an iris scanning. So it depends from organization to organization. But how does this actually work? The system there, let's take in case of this example, has a fingerprint scanner. Now, the first time that I'm presenting my fingerprint, it scans the fingerprint and considers this as part of an enrollment process. From this fingerprint template, what it does is that it extracts certain key features which makes it different from others and stores it into a database. From then forward, every time that I place my finger on top of this fingerprint scanner, it creates a template and compares this with all the templates that's present in the database. If it matches, then it correspondingly, let's say, gives me an attendance or lets me access a door. If it does not, then it raises an alert with respect to that same. Now, this is just a foundation. Now, as I said, this biometric system can be fingerprint, it can be iris scanning, or it can be a combination of both as well. Voice recognition system is one of the key products in the biometric domain. Next, we have smart irrigation system. Now, I am someone who personally likes gardening a lot. Now, this is something that would really make my life easier, because usually what I do is that on Sundays, I spend about 2 hours just watering and looking after my plants. Through a smart irrigation system, what it does is that it checks the moisture present in the environment or in the water lanes that I have created. Now, to help you understand how it works, usually there are 2 main Internet of Things devices that are used here, which is the Arduino board and the Raspberry Pi. Your Raspberry Pi becomes the main processing unit, and I place an Arduino board for each of my water channels. These Arduino boards themselves are connected to multiple sensors which are part of this water channel. So what these sensors do is that they check the moisture present in these lanes as such. So let's say a specific lane does not meet the minimum required moisture, then what it would do is that it would send a signal to the Raspberry Pi. Again, all these devices are connected on the same wireless router network, and the Raspberry Pi would identify the lack of moisture and pass a signal to the relay. The relay in turn would initiate the water pump, and water would be pumped. Now, in order to ensure that water is not wasted, we would create gate controls, and only the gate where the moisture is less would the gate be open. Once my sensor detects that the moisture level has gone beyond my required level, it would again send another signal to the Raspberry Pi asking it to stop the pump as well. So this in turn helps you to save a lot of water and also makes your life quite easier as well. So after this, your only task in your garden would be either setting up new plants or creating new water channels as such. The next project in our list is a security camera and door unlock system. Now, this is something that's quite interesting, and I've personally tried this out, and it's really something that you should try out as well. Here, what happens is that you place a camera on top of a door, which in turn clicks the photo of a person who comes into the frame. Now, this photo is again sent to an analytical system, which in turn compares this with all the photos that it possesses in order to identify whether to let the user open the door or not. Now, an evolution to this is that if it does not find the photo of that person, it can notify the concerned person that so-and-so person is trying to access this door. Would you like to authorize this person and add his information to the database, or would you like to deny the access to this person as well? Usually, this is used in areas where you have high sensitive information stored in order to maintain a strict control to the access to this information as well. Another usage of the security camera and door unlock system can be even at our homes, when we can identify who's come at our home when we're not there and either decide to give them access to our homes or not. Now, the next thing is something that we all really desire to have, which is a smart home system. A smart home system can be something that really makes our life quite easy. starting from energy management, where the light control systems, the AC, the appliances that we use, the thermostat, all this is managed. In short, trying to cut down the power consumption that's taking place. My door management system is also part of this. My security system is also part of this. My water management system again becomes a part of this as well. Again, these are key things that really stands out in the smart home system. But again, what I would personally recommend is that a smart home's limitations is where our imagination stops. Anything that you wish to automate or wish to make your life easier can be part of a smart home system as well. Now, a smart home usually is going to be a base for our next project, which is a smart city. A smart city is an evolution of a smart home. Here, it's not just the sensors of a single home that is connected. Here, it's a correlation or a network or a connection between various organizations, various domains, as well as various segments of that city as a whole as such. Here, the life of every single dependent person in that city becomes easier as a whole as well, and in turn will really help develop that city to greater extents as such. Now, the key factor here for a smart city is a government support as well. And if governments are really willing to take this step, then I hope we would see a smart city completely built on Internet of Things, maybe in the next 5 to 10 years as well. Now, the next project is something that really stands out on a personal level. This is Zelda's Ocarina controlled home automation system. This is personally something that I feel is the closest to a smart home system, where most of the elements of the home is completely controlled by an ocarina. What Alan Pan has done here is that he's created a node-based recognition system which completely automates his home. But rather than telling more about this, let's just look at a quick video which will give you a glimpse into how he has done this and what has he done. Next on our list, at number one, if you've not already guessed, is Jarvis. Jarvis is the artificial intelligence system that Facebook's creator Mark Zuckerberg has built for his home automated system. I'm quite sure you've already seen the video of Mark Zuckerberg interacting with Jarvis, which has Morgan Freeman's voice. And if you've not, here's a quick glimpse into the same.
Good morning, Jarvis.
Good morning, Mark. It's Saturday, so you only have 5 meetings. Room temperature is set to a cool 68 degrees.
Earlier this year, I started building a simple AI to help run our home.
I talked to Jarvis using this app I built. It uses artificial intelligence to understand me and figure out what to do.
Max woke up a few minutes ago. I'm entertaining her.
All right, let's go check on her.
Good morning, Max. Let's practice our Mandarin.
Zhao Shengmao.
Jarvis, your Mandarin is so soothing.
Xie xie.
Jarvis also helps me get ready in the morning. Fresh shirt.
Fire in the hole.
Hell yeah. Jarvis knows when to make me breakfast.
Your toast is ready.
All right. It's time for my call with Shrep. Can you get him on the video conference line?
Setting up the VC room now. Remember to check on the AI guidance system for Aquila.
One of the best things about Jarvis is it could recognize people at the gate, let them in automatically, and then just tell me about it.
Mark, your parents are coming in.
Thanks, Jeffrey.
It's Jarvis.
And Jarvis can play all of our favorite music. Hey, play us some good Nickelback songs.
I'm sorry, Mark. I'm afraid I can't do that. There are no good Nickelback songs.
Good. That was actually a test. Okay, how about just play some songs that our whole family likes?
The itsy bitsy spider climbed up the water spout.
What? I'm a dad now. This is what I listen to.
Now, what you need to understand here is that Internet of Things is not something that's just dependent on a sensor or a few sensors which is connected to a Raspberry Pi on Arduino port. When I look at the entire architecture of IoT, this is a complete ecosystem wherein my sensors gather information, which is again stored on a platform and then processed on this. Now, if there have been any issues or failures that have been reported by these sensors, then I need to create actionable items in order to ensure that this is never really repeated again. But the information, once it's been processed, the processed data is then passed into machine learning and artificial intelligence in order to understand, analyze, and identify various patterns that's out there and help pass this information on back to the sensor. This in turn helps you have a better experience and also improve the system as a whole. A system where I come home every day at 8:30, start off my AC, wait for 15 minutes for it to cool down, is a tedious process. But say today my Internet of Things platform identifies this pattern, already switches on the AC at 8:15, then I just need to come home and I can relax right away. This is just one of the key examples or one of the key ideas that's out there today. And the limitation here again is just your imagination. So with this, we're going to come to a conclusion of this video, but we are going to come up with a lot more videos on Internet of Things and the various projects around that. So if there's some project that really you want to know more about, please let us know in the comment section below. With this, thank you and goodbye.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!